justice for Trayvon Martin, who was killed by George Zimmerman. And it was that he claimed he was acting self-defense. But in a sense, he was aggressive. And even Jeb Bush, who spoke here this past Friday, said that the Self-Defense Act didn't cover George Zimmerman because Trayvon Martin had turned his back. So that's why we're here today, just on behalf of him, to speak up for somebody that can't speak for themselves.
And there's an outrage among the community, it seems, especially the black community, about this act, correct?
Yes, in particular. But we want to make it not just a black thing, because in the end it's a human being. And particularly because we must learn to live together, in a sense, to understand one another. It seems a lot of this came about because of the negative stereotypes that are on the black male at times, and being considered a thug, suspicious, a criminal. And in order to counteract that at times, a lot of families have to tell their young sons, you know, be aware when you go out, be careful how you present yourself, be very polite because of how we're perceived at times. But we just don't want to make it just a black problem, because it's about understanding one another, where we come from, and creating a conversation so we can put an end to the racism and discrimination and violence that's in the world. At least be a part of the solution.
Is this something that maybe could be waited on a little bit as the judicial process works in Florida, and as we find out exactly what really happened, because none of us really know?
Yes, that's true. None of us really know. But from the details of it, what's been presented, and I've been watching it all weekend long with CNN, it seems like it's common sense, because Trayvon was unarmed. It was coming from the store, I believe. He had some Skittles, a tea, and a cell phone. But George Zimmerman was pursuing him. They got into a scuffle. And in the end, you know, he's killed. And he was the one that was unarmed. George Zimmerman was the one with the gun. If anybody that life should have been at stake that was threatened was Trayvon. But George Zimmerman thought his was, and he chose to kill him. And I want to say this, we're not trying to demonize and dehumanize George Zimmerman, because he's a human being at the end as well, made up of good and bad. But in this case, like we all do at times, he made a bad decision. And we're just here advocating for justice because of the decision he's made.
Can I get your full name and spelling, please?
My name is David Butler, Jr. I'm the political action chair of the NAACP here at University of Texas at Arlington.
Normal spelling?
Normal
spelling for your name?
DavidButlerJr.
Yeah, good job.
Good job,
David.
Tell me what you're doing all day. I missed that part.
Oh, no, well. You don't want to do your job.
Yeah, but you can.
We are here today, the NAACP, here at UTA, just advocating for justice for Trayvon Martin, a young teen who was killed on February 26, 2012. And we're just out here trying to create awareness, peaceful protests, and just getting people aware of what's going on, and hopefully, you know, starting a conversation about the problems in our world with just racism and discrimination, racial profile, and the negative stereotypes that are sometimes put on the black male at times specifically. But just the problems with stereotypes in general, you know, we must start a conversation and quit having a misunderstanding about things. But hopefully that will lead to a more better society, in a sense, because, you know, we either going to live together as, you know, brothers and sisters, or pair together as fools. And that's one thing I'm just really advocating for, is just bringing everybody together. I want to see black, white people, Asian people, the diversity amongst this campus to really be about change and starting just a positive movement, a peaceful movement. We're not trying to start up anything. We're not really being angry in a sense, but, you know, it is a righteous indignation that we're really taking account for and being about. So this march that we're doing for Trayvon Martin.
You talked about stereotypes. What are some of the stereotypes that maybe Trayvon fell victim to?
The negative stereotypes that you're sometimes perceived as up to no good, the suspicious aspect of it, even that you're a threat, He was in a gated community on his way to his father's house, who lived there, and the fact that George Zimmerman thought, oh, you know, who is this because he had on a hoodie. That's why we have the hoodies on today, just trying to break. You know, I see so many college students around here wear hoodies all the time, and when it's cold especially. But for some reason, you know, he thought like, oh, something's not right here. He's up to no good. You chose to pursue him. Went after him, started driving in his car, even after the police dispatcher said not to. You know, he disregarded that and still went after him. This just seems like the negative stereotypes that's there that plagues the black man growing up here in America. It's just also what we want to highlight on within this march. You know, it's not just a black problem. We don't want to just make it specifically that, because it's about the whole of humanity working together to create a better community.
Talk about that. You say it's not just a black problem. Whose problem is it? And why is it? Okay, just whose problem is it?
It's a human problem on an individual level and a society level. Because, I mean, it starts with the individuals. Then the individuals in society play an impact. Especially, that's why we want to bring a group together, a collective body of people. You know, it's sending a message to the world and saying that this injustice is not okay. And I hope that, you know, again, it just starts a conversation amongst people. And it's just a part of the solution, because we're not the only, you know, march or anybody doing this. It's been in Florida. It's been in other states, Washington. But it hopefully it's playing the impact and being not a part of the problem, but a part of the solution.
You talk about these marches. Can these really make a difference?
We hope so. You know, by the cameras catching what we say, and it's showing that it's not just like Trayvon Martin and their family, or like the mom and dad. This is not just their problem alone. What affects one directly affects all indirectly. You know, I'm obligated to my brother and my sister to help them as well. It's bigger than that. It's bigger than just, you know, just one alone problem. And I hope this march starts a conversation, starts awareness once again, and creating a conversation. We have to talk about these things on a daily, I think. Sometimes we feel we're such in a post-racial society, you know, with President Obama being in office, but stuff still plagues. You know, we've come a long way. I would credit that because of the sacrifice that it made, not only by black people, but by white people, Asians. We've come a long way, but we still have a long way to go. There's always progress that can be made. There's always room for improvement.
What will happen today, or what's the plan for this demonstration?
The plan is, we're gonna we're starting at what time is it now? I believe
it's 5 after.
We're gonna start the march specifically at 12, and we're gonna, you know, march through campus, and hopefully, you know, everybody collectively together is standing up for justice for Trayvon. You know, this is not only the only case that have happened like this. There's been plenty others, but since this one is now out in the national media, you know, hopefully it's creating a good conversation about race relations and how we can make things better.
Tell me about your petition. Petition?
Oh, the petition, you can actually sign it online. I signed it on Facebook. It's sent to me. It's just a petition saying that, you know, you want justice served for Trayvon, and seeing George Zimmerman, you know, the justice being paid out, him playing the penalty for his actions. And I said this before, we're not trying to demonize or dehumanize George Zimmerman, because he's a human being at the end of the day, like us all, made of good and bad. But in this case, like us all at times, he made a bad decision, and we feel that he should own up to it. You know, it's kind of sad to see he didn't have any type of remorse or anything. He's a young kid. He was innocently trying to make his way to his father's house. And it's just, I mean, he got killed that way. The fact that, you know, not only his life got cut short, but he lost his life that way, and then the family dealing with it. That's a tough thing. You know, it's very tough.
Well, your name and title?
My name is David Butler Jr. I'm the political action chair of the NAACP here at the University of Texas.
Spell your last name.
B-U-T-L-E-R.
You mentioned the petition. What are you guys doing with that?
We are. I know, particularly, I signed mine online. You know, I got it through online. I think that's what majority of us have been doing, signing it online. I think we may have a concrete one here today, hopefully. But that's just the main thing that we want people to sign it, to show that, you know, this injustice is not okay. This is speak up for.
How was the UTA is a pretty diverse campus. How does that play into what you guys are, you know, what you guys are able to say, what you guys are able to do?
It plays such a major factor in this, just not being like a HBCU, a historical black college. But it's showing that it's just not a black problem. Hopefully we get a diversity and collective amongst the people, because that's what the world is made of. And consciously hoping it sparks the mind and saying like, oh, you know, who is Trayvon? Or I heard about it. And it's creating a conversation amongst black people, white people, Asian, Hispanics, you know, multiracial, biracial. The diversity amongst this campus plays a major effect in hopefully showing the impact of how a student body can come together across races, across gender.
Can you spell your last name for me, David?
B-U-T-L-E-R.
B-U-T-L-E-R. Thanks so much, my friend. And you're a political action chair for the university NAACP?
Yes, here at...
Very cool. What's your major?
My major is social work, actually. Plan on going to grad school. I'm a senior here.
Senior.
Plan on going to grad school and, you know, just trying to be a part of the solution. And, you know, with God's help, just do the right thing.
Very cool. Thanks so much, David.
All right. What's your name?
Casey.
Casey, nice to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, I'm an